Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Anusha Prabhakaran. I'm working as a professor in psychiatry at Pramukh Swami Medical College and as a psychiatrist at Shree Krishna Hospital. 10th October 2019 is being celebrated as World Mental Health Day worldwide. This year's theme is prevention of suicide. This is an opportunity to raise awareness about a very important and so often neglected issue, that is suicide. Every 40 seconds, someone loses their life to suicide. Each loss is not only a tragedy for that particular person, but also for the friends, community, and their family which they leave behind. Young people represent the future, yet suicide is the second leading cause of death among 15 to 29 years age group. Suicide can affect anyone. Contrary to the popular belief, it is not only prevalent in high-income countries, but 80% of the suicide is seen in lower to middle-income countries, where the resources for identifying and supporting those in need are very scarce. Suicide is a result of, you know, convergence of many factors, which may be biological, psychological, and social and cultural. Among biological reasons, there are genetic reasons why somebody commits suicide. Having a family history of suicide, various psychiatric illnesses like depression. Depression is actually one of the major causes of suicide, untreated and, you know, undiagnosed depression. Also, substance use disorder like alcohol is another contributor of suicide. Other psychiatric disorders like bipolar mood disorder, schizophrenia and personality disorder also leads to suicide. There may be other psychological reasons, that is how a person copes with stress in their lives. That is also one of the reasons why somebody would commit suicide. Various stressful life events like having, you know, financial problems, unemployment, poor social relationships, poor social support, failure in exams, failure in love, all these are another social and cultural reasons for suicide. The presence of various chronic medical illness which have poor prognosis and which are painful conditions are also considered one of the major risk factors for suicide. Other risk factors include a previous attempt of suicide. Fortunately, suicide is preventable. There are various strategies which work. First is raising awareness in breaking stigma so that people come forward and seek help. Other strategies which work are restricting access to means of suicide, encouraging media to provide stories of hope, using non-sensational language while reporting suicide, supporting young people in school and colleges, because we need to help them develop good coping skills by giving them good life skill education. These are the strategies which have worked worldwide to prevent suicide. We all have a role to play. On this World Mental Health Day, I encourage each one of you, whether you are a healthcare worker, whether you are a parent, whether you are a teacher, or if you are a media person, you go ahead and learn more about suicide prevention and go out and reach out to people who require this help. By simply checking on someone, if you feel that they are in distress, ask them, are you okay? By encouraging them to tell their stories, listening to them in an empathic and compassionate way, you can encourage them and motivate them and make them feel empowered to go ahead and seek help, seek professional help. Together we all can save lives. We at Shree Krishna Hospital are providing services from psychiatry department to cure all sort of, to treat all sort of psychiatric disorders and psychological problems. We have a qualified team of 5 psychiatrists and 1 clinical psychologist. We offer pharmacotherapy, psychotherapy, counseling services, and various psychological testing is done over here. We also offer specific services like child guidance clinics, de-addiction services, etc. Thank you.